Welcome to this part 2 video on the attempted assassination on Raila Odinga. Now, there are a few things that happened during Raila Odinga's visit to the US this time that would have made the assassination attempt not surprising. Okay, as bad as it was, that is really what it is. For starters, the unprecedented surveillance. Okay, we reported in this channel earlier on that quite a number of agents were following Raila Odinga around, monitoring his activities. There are all sorts of gadgets used to monitor exactly every move Raila Odinga was making during his US trip. And of course, in the earlier, as we pointed out in the earlier recording, this was strange because the local intelligence outfit already has a fairly good network in the US, which would have been able to gather any information that they might have ordinarily required. Yes, and this is due to historical reasons. Anyway, the surveillance was a very clear pointer that definitely there was something cooking. Since the beginning of time, it has been standard procedure to have very close surveillance of assassination targets. Some of the obvious reasons are you would want to know their movements so as to be able to create a plan that would succeed. Yes, because assassination is not as easy as people think it is. It's not just a matter of pulling a trigger. It needs to be very well organized to succeed. Indeed, virtually every single political assassination in the history of Kenya has always been preceded by complaints, sometimes by the victim, that they're being followed. Okay? This time for Raila in the US, it was so serious that a number of key meetings had to be held in personal residences of people, with only a select few present, in order to be sure that the meeting was not under any kind of surveillance. The second very clear sign was the fact that Raila Odinga's security team appeared to be aware of some threat on his life. The extra unprecedented precautions taken, including bulletproof jacket, and also the extra layer of security that was created, definitely points to the fact that they were aware that the leader was in danger. They were aware that there could be an attempt, for his life. The state-of-the-art bulletproof Range Rover that Raila used from the airport to get to his house, through the city, of course, is an example of the extra precautions that were taken this time round. And judging from Winnie Odinga's tale of what unfolded on Jogoo Road, clearly this bulletproof Range Rover saved Raila Odinga's life. Now, they say a cat has 9 lives, but I'd say Raila probably has 19. I've laughed, but I'm very serious. Raila Odinga has had too many brushes with death to even count. Let me point out a few. In 1982, after the activities, the failed coup of 1982, Raila Odinga was charged with treason. But instead of going to the gallows, he was detained without trial for 6 years. For the sake of younger Kenyans, when people were detained without trial in those days, it was not specified for how long they would be detained, It was indefinitely, So as luck would have it, after 6 years, an opportunity came and he was released. An opportunity for him to be released came because the political climate in the country was changing very rapidly. And that's how he got released after 6 years, Otherwise, people used to spend 10, 20 years. In fact, Kenyans even died in detention without trial. But perhaps Raila's most dramatic brush with death happened in 1991, and I believe it was around October. He had just been released on 21st of June of that year, and he was crossing, he was actually on Lake Victoria in a small boat, and he was crossing over to Uganda from where he jetted to Norway and got political asylum. Now, a very interesting nugget of information was released by General Sombeuo, who wrote an autobiography of his life in the military. Now, apparently, as Raila was fleeing the country, unknown to him, he was under surveillance of the intelligence community. And as he got onto the boat there in Lake Victoria, he was on the crosshairs of a sniper. Yeah? And this sniper was just waiting for orders to fire. Okay? Well, fortunately, the orders never came through. And Raila safely crossed Lake Victoria into Uganda and went to Norway on political asylum. Now, many people do not know the source of one of Raila's nicknames, Agwambo. Many people do not know where that came from. Yeah, there's a lot of speculation, okay? But let me just tell you the bottom line today. Now, there are many cases where Raila had very close shaves, as we have been talking in this video. In fact, in one instance, what happened, people had been sent to pick him up, yeah, and probably make him disappear, if you get my meaning. Yes, it is said that they approached the gate of where Raila was, and they spoke to a man on a bicycle, yes, and asked him if that person had seen Raila, you know, in that homestead. That person replied in the negative, and he rode off in his bicycle. Now, what these people did not know that person they had spoken to riding that bicycle was in fact Raila Odinga himself. The incidence, of course, implies that he's either, in his younger days, he was either a master of disguise or he had some mysterious powers, yeah, that would enable him to slip through dangerous situations, yes? Actually, Agwambo means the mysterious one. Mysterious, unpredictable. The general thing is there's an aura of mystery around him, yes? He's not a very easy person to pin down. Yes, that's really what it means. Yeah, Raila is an old man now, but he's still in the game, okay? Very interesting that some of the people who opened their mouths to hurl insults at Raila were in their napkins, when Raila was already in the trenches. Yeah, napkins, because those days there were no pampers, eh? Yeah, the bottom line is that there were babies, yeah, who had to be taken care of, who used to pass stool and pass urine, and get changed and so on. Yeah, that's the extent most of these people opening their mouths to hurl insults at Raila were in, when Raila was already in the trenches and facing life and getting a very hard time fighting for justice and the rights of people. And that is a fact, because the truth is, it is good to respect a person who deserves to be respected, no matter what side of the political divide you stand. Yeah, you don't need to be a fanatical Raila follower. I'm not a fanatical Raila follower. Indeed, there are a lot of things I criticize about his style. But when you need to respect a man, respect him. Yes, because this is a great Kenyan who deserves respect. And that is a fact. Anyway, in the final episode of this series, we'll look at the political implications and maybe the political motive for wanting to eliminate Raila Odinga, okay? Especially at this time when the country is in so much political turmoil, okay? Make sure you catch it. Link on the top left-hand corner as soon as it's ready, and you'll be on to that part. This is Chris Komekucha.